Social media has become so much a part of our lives, but it also can become a distraction from our lives. It's very easy to get sucked into the rabbit hole of Facebook. Here today to talk more about it is Dr. Josh Claypool, clinical psychologist. So, social media, is it helping us? Is it hurting us?
Yes, it's both. It is. It can help us, it can hurt us. Like anything else, and a lot of it has to do with how much we're using it, and more importantly than how much, is it disrupting our lives? And, you know, or is it disrupting the lives of people around us? Those are the two key components that you really need to look at to figure out, is this a good thing or a bad thing?
So are we addicted?
I would say yes, for a lot of us. But again, addiction really, when you think about addiction, what we want to think about is, are we doing something even though it's not good for us, or even though it's harming us? And so the litmus test that I like to give people is, take your phone or your computer or your iPad or whatever it is, and if you disconnect, if you leave your phone at home and let's say you find yourself without it, what's happening to you internally? Are you just constantly cycling, I gotta get that phone, I gotta get back online, I gotta get connected, I gotta get connected, I need to go check Facebook, I need to go check. If that's going on, then there's a good chance that not so much you're addicted, but that your habit is really, really strong. The other test is, look at the people around you. Do you have family members or friends or your kids who are saying, you know, can you put your phone down? Can you stop checking your Twitter account? Can you stop? You're not paying attention. If those things are going on, chances are you probably need to sort of pare it back.
So if you are watching this and you all of a sudden realize, hey, wait, that is me, what can you do?
You don't so much, everyone's afraid, oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to go cold turkey. You don't. Really what you need to do is set some parameters for yourself. So for example, if it's social media that you kind of get sucked into and you're there way too long, put a timer on. Give yourself 20 minutes, give yourself 30 minutes. Also pay attention to what's going on in your life. So if you're using social media but you're also late for appointments or you're late for your kids' events or your family's reminding you to look up and pay attention, those are easy things that you can just sort of pare back and dial it back enough so that you can still use it, but it's not disrupting your life or the life of people around you.
So the other problem I've heard of a lot with social media is people losing sleep. They'll be looking at their phones late at night. Is this something that people should not do?
You're really not supposed to do that. Now, I know a lot of people like to kind of scroll through and check the news and just do the kinds of things like that. But again, something like a timer or an alarm where you're cueing yourself, because we do get very engaged. So even if you're looking at it at night, although I wouldn't recommend it, set an alarm for yourself so that at a certain time, maybe it's 10 o'clock at night, which is when you need to go to bed, that's when you know I put it down and I go to bed. As a general rule though, if you're looking at night, staying up late, tired the next morning, that's a signal in and of itself that you're using technology in a way that's disrupting your life.
Is there anything else that we should keep in mind when it comes to social media?
I'd be careful to say that it's good or bad. It is. And how we use it can either be good or bad. That's up to us, not up to the technology.